and taking four people out to lunch and paying the bill themselves. So you have to make sure that everybody's benefit gets accounted for.
Trustee Lodato just asked the question if you want to.
Well, no, I was just curious when she was referring to the mini malls. Does she mean like a strip mall as like where AutoZone and
Verizon? That's the word, strip mall, thank you. I could not think of that, yeah.
And then could we charge each one, well, each individually instead of the entire?
Well, you know, what we have is, it's already built, hasn't been completed nor occupied. But we have a structure with three spaces in there. One is orange, is a bagel place, so that would fall under a restaurant, I'm assuming, or diner.
Fast food, yeah, restaurant, fast food, diner.
And then there's two other spaces that have yet to, you know, to be assigned. But it's our intention to have each space meet it separately.
And that's the issue. It depends on how anything that's currently existing is metered. And like I said, several of these, the strip mall, for example, might be owned by a certain overarching company, and they rent each space to someone else who has their use in it. So the customer is actually the overall owner, and all of the uses are put into one meter. So the assignment for units according to the use of each space. And that's what those little two asterisks mean.
Okay. Anyone on the board have any questions?
I was just curious, if we come across a business or a situation and we don't know what number is appropriate for that, is it us that decides the number?
Yeah, but we can put in the code when we update that, and the intent of this is any discrepancies are decided by the board. Then the schedule of units itself says this schedule refers to domestic or sanitary sewage. So if there's any need for industrial, I don't think you've got any larger industrials that have, and your sewer treatment folks would know about this, if they have a lot of EOD or a lot of solids or a lot of something that creates a problem for the wastewater treatment plant, that's often a different charge. That doesn't have to do with this one.
Okay. All right, anyone else? Trustee Kalor? Did you want to unmute him?
Hold on,
yes, I'm here.
Okay. Any questions?
No.
Okay. Anyone from the public?
Paul.
Paul has his hand raised. Paul, you're on.
Hey, hello, Tracy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm okay.
I got a couple of questions. On the schedule of facility storage units, who comes up with that number of the number of units?
I did, based on the benefits to each type of property. This is something that as a company we've done in several different counties in New York State so far. The idea is to get away from assessed value, which does not reflect the benefit of use at all. And the thought is that if a particular type of property, be it industrial, commercial, hospital, you know, anything, has a much greater benefit than, you know, having that service is making money off it, or otherwise couldn't run their, you know, it's bigger than a single family home, so it's sort of like a ratio, if you will. But those larger benefiting folks, if they're not paying according to their benefit, then the single family homes wind up paying that cost that's not being paid. So we try to make this as fair and equitable as possible, and we have had several hearings on this. It's always possible in the future, if issues are brought up, to modify this.
And are you aware that the Brotherhood Winery is billed in cubic feet of water, not gallons?
No, I don't think I saw that.
Yeah, I believe, it's a good point, Paul.
It's running cubic feet, not gallons.
I believe the, I don't know about the middle school at Taft, but I believe the high school does also, correct?
One of them might, I know the winery does.
Yeah.
Took me to definitely.
Okay, then if you think that you.
The village lost a lot of money in the past on that building.
Yeah, so I mean, that's.
That would relate to the facility, the amount of water being, you know, relating to the facility charge.
Right, so that's easy enough to convert gallons to cubic, it's a cubic feet or cubic yards?
I think it's feet, yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's easy enough to convert, but you need to be aware of that and it needs to get into your software. So if you can make sure I get a list of those meters that are like that, then I can work on that.
And that would just be for the winery, which is the manufacturing, if that's what is gonna fall under, correct?
Yeah, and that just relates to the operation and maintenance charge, it doesn't really relate to the benefit.
So, and then going back to the, how to rate, the new rates will be structured, as a resident, I wanna know, and I think that your last presentation, you said the average use of 14,000 gallons. You say how the new rate would be structured. On this here, on this page here, on that one right there, you have 1893 connections with water, and you have 1867 connections with sewer. How'd you come up with the 1867 sewer?
There are several accounts that do not have sewer. They might get water from the village and have a septic system. That is something else that needs to be verified on a regular basis.
How many of those did you come up with?
Those I came up with from the information I was given from the village.
How many have water and no sewer?
The difference between 1,893 and 1,867, what is that?
What about the units like the building right behind the village hall that has 17 sewer connections, or the dance studio on South Street that has 4, or the apartment houses on East Main Street that have multiple sewer connections?
It's not exactly the sewer connection, it's current page that's up right now, right?
No. Well, is it on there?
Yeah, it's right here.
It's closer to the fair as well.
Yeah, it's 4313, but on the other one, you have, you don't have 4313, you have, okay, stay on that page for a second, let's stay on that page for a second.
It's, yeah, this is right here, yes.
All right, I'm going over, but we're gonna go somewhere else. So, 377, so 377, there's a minimum usage of 7,000 gallons, right?
Right. So if you use less than 7,000 gallons, you would be twenty.
So, 377 times seven, on my calculator, comes up to 2639, instead of 2622.
Tracy, this has to do with.
It's just the way the Excel spreadsheet makes, lengthens things out.
Okay.
And this is a very good example, it's not the coming up, that's not the real budget that we'll be starting next year.
Can you go to that page that says new schedule of units?
Got what?
Wait.
Okay, what, come on, what are you doing? Current $15 a year billing, right?
Yes.
Existing units, I lived in, from existing units, that what I am?
No, the existing units are the current in the village code assignment, so it, as a single family residence, you're still just for one, an assignment of one.
Where is one unit on it, go?
It's assumed, because this is a single family home, and this is the cost for one unit.
That's what it says, and so that's what I'm saying, existing unit of a single family home, so my annual cost would be 45. If the resident wants to see how much that would go, and we determine that 377 by 58 went back. So now my annual facility cost would be 2560 water, correct?
No, the current charge per unit is $15 per unit. Using the units assigned and splitting them into water and sewer, right now your current $15 per unit per quarter is, it's only in the village code is being used for sewer, and it doesn't cover the current debt. The existing units term in this one is the example, using the existing assignment of units as the existing village code, but splitting, giving you a water unit and a sewer unit, which raises the cost a little bit. The new unit is the new method.
I know.
Excuse me?
$59.
Yes, yeah, you add the 45.62.
$59.86 would be the single family home.
That's according to the current village code, which we are restructuring. The new units list is a simple restructuring without adding new sewer debt. So if you compare how the village does it now, if water and sewer were split, that would be your charge per unit.
It's the one, we need to look at this bottom one. You mean this month, this year, 2022, that's what the water and the facilities is, for the water and sewer, for the year.
Paul, this chart right here is basically giving you the comparison of the different methods that are being used.
I have a full one here.
Largest.
I don't think.
The new sewer debt.
I don't think people, or the average resident, you know, understand that. So me, if I'm using 7,000 gallons minimum, and a facility would be, so me, a fixed ton, right?
Right. Use the last line. The last line is going to be the best estimate of the upcoming budget, because that is the new unit structure and the new sewer debt coming up in 2022.
But that's for the average water use.
The annual.
That's the average water use. But that, it's not relevant to the facility charge. It's only for the facility charge for debt service.
Right, exactly. So that's $164.66.
Right.
For a year.
And I think it's really easier to go down to that other chart and look at that, because that's more specific.
but I'm just saying, well, the average person looking at this, you know, not elevated, literally, per unit, 30, 45, still, or 10, 30, 40.
Right, so a single-family home is assigned one unit for water and one unit for sewer, so this works as out as a single-family home. Now, if you're a commercial that was assigned three units, you would have to calculate that as three times that cost of unit, because you have three units.
These two, this is the unit, 43, 13, 14, 21, quarter, so these two, you add to that.
So, it's...
If I do my math right, Paul, can you hear me? If I did my math right, the 7,000 minimum with the facilities charge and the water and sewer combined, with both facility charges and water and sewer usage, comes out to 106.48 quarter for 7,000 gallon minimum. Well, this is an estimate for now until the budget comes up.
Yeah. I think that thing is not that much of a difference. It's not, you know, it's not a huge leap.
Right.
Your water bill's not going to double. It's not.
Right.
And it hasn't been raised in 20 years.
Yeah.
And actually, for some of those commercials and other users that are not single-family homes, the facility charge is going to decrease because they're no longer based on assessed value. They're based on
that.
Everybody happy. Our goal is to make everyone happy.
Most people who are not happy will get free donuts.
Okay, is there anyone else on the Zoom right now that has comments? The public portion of this meeting for the water and sewer rate restructuring. It is 7:55.
I'll make a motion to close the meeting.
That's Trustee Kolor.
The hearing.
Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Trustee Sampson. Roll call. Trustee Kolor.
Yes.
Trustee Sampson.
Yes.
Trustee Kolor.
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Lodato.
Yes.
Mayor Buckner. Yes. Okay. Tracy, thank you so much for the presentation. I will be reaching out to you later on this week to get you to, because we do have to adopt a new law, a new local laws, based on the information, and we will have to get you in touch with our water programmers. I did have a brief conversation with them last week, and they are. Have been doing this for many of their clients already, so.
Yeah, and I know it's doable. We just need to get down to the details of what that spreadsheet that I give them needs to look like, and I might need to make some functional changes
right.
Just on the way mine is set up. That's fine.
And what I will do is reach out to somehow, we need to get the laundromat in some type of business, some type of category. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Okay, so how do I, yeah, let me share. Yes. All right.
Yeah, there it is.
Okay.
Joe, now, Joe, can I interrupt?
Absolutely, sure.
So, so we just closed the meeting, is that it, or we vote on anything, or adopting this new system?
We do have to adopt it, yes, we do have to adopt it, so I need a motion. You could interrupt me anytime, especially for questions like this.
I'll make a motion to adopt the new water sewer rates as just recently presented.
Okay, I need a second.
I'll second.
Deputy Mayor Lodato, second. Okay, roll call, trustee Kolar.
Yes.
Trustee Sampson.
Yes.
Trustee Kolar.
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Lodato.
Yes.
Mayor Bucko, yes, thank you, Rich, appreciate it. Okay, in front of you on the screen, you will see a preliminary multi-fund budget. You can see on the, I took last year's numbers, the 2021-2022, and put with 2022-2023, and the percentage of change that we see in here. I'm not going to go through each line item, but we have on the bottom line of the new, with the proposed budget on the Village Hall is $274,385. It's 11.33% increase from last year on this category. You will also see that I took some of the utilities, keeping the same numbers, but just allocated them in a different part of the budget. The municipal services, last year we had $73,400. This year, $89,900. And we have a increase, percentage of change of 24.48%.
22.
I'm sorry, 22.48%. It's right in front of me, Bill. Shared services, and this is where I took, if you look here at the last two items, the first aid and meals, I took that out of the police line item to put in shared services, because that's really where it's coming from. The first aid is for all three departments, and the meals, also travel, so I have to put meals and travel. It's coming from, again, at least the two departments, the DPW as well as the police department. We have an increase of this here of 1,220%. Last year, this line item, this portion was $416,400. And the new budget is $548,900. And again, all of this is preliminary. So we need to start tightening the numbers to make it work for all of us.
I just think that the 1,200% is not, can't be right. I think it's going to impact itself.
Okay. Yeah. Normally happens with,
I don't want anybody freaking out that they're
there.
Just leave it there for a second.
Okay.
It's 31.8%.
Okay, so it's 31.8% increase. I'm just going to write it here, 31.8%. Increase. I guess I should put it here, 31.8% increase. Thank you, trustee.
Math, trustee.
Yes, and I know trustee Lodato's here laughing, saying, ha, ha, ha.
No, I'm laughing because you moved my formulas. I'm gonna block cells on these things.
You said, three home.
This portion was a reduction of numbers, continued personnel expense, minus 91%, so we have a minus 29.12%. Moving over to the law enforcement, we have a 0.67% increase over last year. These numbers I received from Chief Zaccaro. This does have, if you look here, it's all the...
Does it include potential contractual?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Gotcha.
The public safety portion, electric, school, and zone lights, it's the maintenance. Now, if you notice, one of those, and this happens to be in front of Taft, there's no longer a blinking light heading towards Taft. Parking division equipment, I know the board, Rich and I have had endless conversations on making the old Village Hall parking lot a paid parking facility. So with these numbers, it's probably been in discussion for 5 years, at least. It's a minus 4%. Sanitation, that's not trash pickup. It has to do with the storm sewer drainage and DEC projects. We are moving along with this, so we actually took a $10,000 decrease with this. Our biggest issue that we have is the disposal of some of the material. Code enforcement, we do have building inspectors on staff. This was $104,000 was last year, $130,000 was proposed, so we have a total increase of 24.93% in this line, in this group. Highways and streets are DPW. You look down here, now we have to purchase some street equipment. I know Chris Martino, the superintendent, has been asking for a hot box, which will heat up the asphalt, which will help them in patching some of the potholes. Now, a question came up with, at the last meeting, a resident said, well, when there used to be a line item for paving the roads, and that line item was removed probably about 4 years ago. All right, if I remember correctly, there was about $150,000, and to be honest with you, they did not pave roads. Since I'm here 32 years, I believe they paved four. I could be mistaken. We paved four. Okay, they paved four. So, in total of 32 years, 8 roads have been paved.
Is that something the town can do since we pay taxes to?
Well, that, I think we need to reach out to the town.
1.3 million.
Yeah. You know, I said at that night, at that meeting that we have, we bond. For
our
paving, and collectively the village residents are sending the town $1.3 million. So we need to find out how much of that money is coming back to the village, okay? And off the top, I don't know if there is. So these are conversations that will be taking place.
How does it come back to us though? Because we have our own police department, DPW, so where's it going?
Well, hopefully the paving road.
Yeah, among other things.
So this is. So it's $1.3 million, it was confirmed by the tax assessor. Trustee Lodato ran numbers last year also.
I requested FOIL.
Requested FOIL, and it was approximately the same number.
Wait, what?